your carrier systems. So right now we're seeing anywhere from 12 to 20 second delay, so just be aware of that when you want to watch launch and then run outside real quick to be able to see the remainder of the flight if you're close, or if you're up in the farther regions to be able to see the vapor release. In about 5 minutes, they'll be conducting and setting their initial launcher settings. These are based on winds. Since about the T-minus 4 hours and 30-minute mark, we have been flying balloons from Wallops to give us the wind activity that's going on anywhere from the ground level to about 100,000 feet. And so this will allow us to, we know we need to hit, it's kind of like shooting a bow, an arrow, and that you need to adjust how you're shooting at your target based on the wind. So we know we have that point in the sky, so to speak, of where we want to hit, and we will make the adjustments to the launcher based on the wind settings or the winds, and to allow us to be able to try to hit that target.
RSO ROA.
Go ahead.
Have any initial wind-weighted launcher settings?
Yes, ma'am. Azimuth 104.4, elevation 81.9.
Copy, 104 azimuth, elevation 81.9.
And that was 104.4.
Copy, 104.4. LC ROA.
LC.
Set ARC launcher to initial settings of 104.4 azimuth, elevation 81.9.
LC copies, in work. LCROA.
Go ahead.
ARC wind weighted settings are 104.4 and elevation 81.9.
Copy.
Readouts go.
We just passed the T-minus 20-minute mark in counting for the launch of the Black Brant 9 suborbital sun rocket from NASA's Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. Again, the main purpose of this flight is to test the modified Black Brant sun rocket motor and look at the characterize that motor's performance in a two-stage configuration.
TDR, so.
Go ahead, sir.
Okay, I'm going to call the range green at this time. Recommend we proceed toward our scheduled launch time.
Copy.
And there you go from the range safety officer that the range is now green, that we worked the ship issues. And so we will be targeting a 7:07 launch this evening. we're coming up on the T-minus 15-minute mark in tonight's countdown. At this point, the range operations assistant will do a poll of the various stations participating to make sure that everybody is ready and green for launch.
All stations, this is the 36.310 Terrier Black Brant launching from Pad 2 ARC launcher. Please stand by for station checks to proceed with the terminal count. All stations should announce status as green or red on channel 1. RC.
RC green.
MNO.
MNO green.
LWO.
LWO is green.
Computer.
Computer is green.
Programmer.
Programmer is green.
LC.
LC is green.
LPM.
LPM green.
PLC.
PLC is green.
PTM.
PTM is green.
EDS.
EDS is green.
OATK.
OATK is green.
Lynch.
Lynch green.
Larson.
Larson green.
PI.
PI green.
MM.
MM green.
SRPO.
SRPO green.
PM.
PM is green.
RSO.
RSO is green.
TD.
TD is green.
All stations are responsible for reviewing the go-no-go criteria listed in the MOD. Only stations annotated with an asterisk in the previous step are permitted to call a hold. All other sites should report red.
And all stations are reported green and ready to go for tonight's launch of the Black Brant 9 suborbital sounding rocket. Our target altitude this morning, apogee, is 162 miles up from the Earth, and it will land in the ocean approximately 132 miles from Wallops out in the Atlantic, and we will not be recovering this payload, so everything will sink to the bottom of the ocean.
RSO, ROA.
ROA, RSO, go ahead.
Provide final wind-weighted launcher settings.
Standby one. ROA, RSO, azimuth 103.5, elevation 81.8.
Copy, LC, ROA.
LC.
Set launcher to 103.5 azimuth, elevation 81.8.
LC copies, in work. ROA LC.
Go ahead.
Final wind weighted settings for ARC is 103.5, 81.8.
Good copy. Check 166.
And the final launcher settings have been put in for the Black Brant 9. Next coming up is T-10 will be the basically the terminal count by the payload systems on the vehicle.
T minus 10 minutes and counting.
Check 168.
GPS on external power.
Yeah. MNO start data and strip chart recorders.
Check 170.
Check 169.
Check 171.
Payload systems are now on external power.
Check 172.
MNO report good luck on all links.
In work.
RC interrogate transponder and verify good 5 code.
In work.
PM MNO, we have good lock on all links. RF parameters are recorded and nominal.
Copy. Check 173 and check 186.
PMRC, we have good 5 code.
Check 174.
MMSRPO, did you catch 168?
Yes, I did.
Copy, thank you.
Just passed the T minus 8 minute mark.
Check 175.
MNO, record parameters.
Parameters recorded and nominal.
Check 177. Check 178.
Check 179.
Check 180. Check 181.
Check 176.
Check 182. Check 183.
Check 184.
Check 185. Targeting launch, tonight's launch for 7:07 p.m. Tonight's flight of the Black Brant 9 is predicted to be approximately 9 minutes long. So it will be flying up to about 162 miles altitude and then impacting approximately 132 miles out from Wallops in approximately 9 minutes after launch.
Read copies.
Coming up on T-minus 3 minutes, at that point, we will switch all systems on the payload to internal power.
Check 187, check 188, check 189.
Check 190.
M&O, verify TM lock and no change in TM signal strength or deviation.
Readout has no change.
PM M&O, TM is unchanged.
Check 191. RC, report on transponder interrogation and verify
good
5-3. Check 194.
TMRC, transponder
check 195.
Check 192.
Check 196.
Check 197.
T-minus 1 minute and 40 seconds to launch the Black Brant 9.
RC, report on transponder interrogation and verify
check 193.
Check 194.
TMRC, transponder
check 195.
Check 192.
Check 196.
Check 197.
T-minus 1 minute and 40 seconds to launch the Black Brant 9.
Check Check 198.
Poll for readiness to proceed to launch. PTM, are you go?
PTM's go.
PLC.
PLC, go.
Orbital ATK.
OATK, go.
Lynch.
Lynch, go.
Larson.
Larson, go.
EDS.
EDS, go.
NASROC payload statuses, go.
PI, announce mission status.
PI, go.
1 minute.
1 minute to go.
Seconds. Minus 40.
LC, arm booster ignition circuit.
Carrier armed.
Minus 30. Minus 20. Minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Black Brant ignition.
Second stage Black Brant motor ignition.
EDS is enabled.
Feet.
Black Brant burnout.
Black Brant motor burnout.
Separation. Nose cone deploy.
Doors 1 and 4 deploy, through 4 deploy.
Doors 5 through 8 deploy. Bob separation. Bob main deploy. Bob ejectable deploy.
PA update. Preliminary data indicating motor performed well.
And the performance of the Black Brant motor was the main purpose of tonight's flight, so that's good news. We expect to see the paper release.
EDS, we have a no deploy on an ejectable number one, which is not expected. We have nominal no deploys from ejectables 5 and 7.
And so we expect to see the vapor tracers at approximately 6 minutes after launch. So it would be at about 7:13 p.m. You should hopefully be able to see the vapor tracers if you have clear skies. And they continue to monitor the flight in the range control center at Wallops. see some of the students that are at hand that participated in the development of the game-changing technology payloads were able to attend tonight's launch.
We're at Apogee.
This is EDS, first chemical dispersion at a 7:13:10 local.
There you have it. The first payload, the first vapor tracer is set to occur at 7:13, so in approximately 1 minute. Just past the 8 minute mark in today's flight.
LOS on TM1.
LOS is loss of signal.
PM, this is MNO on 1. Just wanted to report we have LOS on TM1, but we still have TM2.
Copy that.
LOS TM2.
PM MNO, we have LOS on TM2.
Copy.
Good app. Good job. Fixed.
If you did catch the vapor tracer dispersions, you can go to our Facebook page. And
RSO, ROA.
Let us know what you saw.
Go ahead.
And are we clear to bring down roadblocks?
We are.
Copy. LPM, ROA.
LPM.
You can release the roadblocks at this time.
Copy. We're dropping roadblocks. Security can be released.
Copy. SRPO and MM, you guys good to lower the launcher?
This is MM. We need to take a reading of the launcher first before we lower it.
Copy. LPM, ROA.
LPM, go ahead.
Can you take settings on the launcher before lowering, and you're clear to do so?
LPM copies, then work.
ROA MNO on 1.
Go ahead.
Did you all want any pictures of the launcher?
I don't think so.
Okay, copy all.
And that concludes tonight's
MM,
flight.
This is PM on Channel 1. Do you copy?
Concludes tonight's flight of the Black Brant 9 from Wallops. We did launch tonight at 7:07 p.m. The main purpose of this flight was to test the performance and look at the performance of the Black Brant motor in a two-stage configuration. Preliminary indications are that the motor performed as
planned. MM, this is PM on Channel 1.
This is MM.
Yes, what time can you support a hot wash up here at the conference room at 217?
At this point,
I'm thinking 8 p.m.
Copy that.
Team will do a hot wash of the account and see how everybody felt that the account went tonight and the vehicle. And after that, tomorrow,
this is the PM on Channel 1.
Data analysis.
Hot wash debriefing will occur at 8 p.m. local time in E106 Conference Room 217. Thank you, everyone, for your support, and good job, everyone.
Next launch from here at Wallops is scheduled to be a carrier improved Malamute. That will also be a technology demonstration mission that we'll be flying early in the morning. And so stay tuned for that. Right now we're looking at
Good morning from NASA's Wallops Flight Facility. The countdown is underway this morning for the launch of a two-stage carrier-improved Malamute suborbital sounding rocket. This mission is to fly experiments developed by undergraduate community college and university students from across the United States. The experiments are developed by students from seven higher education programs and are being flown through the RockSat-X program in conjunction with the Colorado Space Grant Consortium. Participating institutions in this flight are the University of Colorado at Boulder, Northwest Nazarene University, the University of Puerto Rico, Virginia Tech, Capital Technology University, and the University of Hawaii Community Colleges. The experiments today are flying as part of an 872-pound payload flying on the two-stage Terrier Improved Malamute.
LPM, this is RSO, Channel 1.
It's LPM.
Yes, sir. Can you please have OSS either give me a call on Channel 10 or here on console at 1588?
Roger.
Thank you.
The launch today is predicted to reach an altitude of 94 miles. The payload with its experiments will descend by parachute when the mission is complete and is expected to land 15 minutes after launch in the Atlantic Ocean, about 63 miles off the Virginia coast. The payload will be recovered, and any experiments and stored data will be provided back to the students later today. Our window this morning runs until 10 a.m. We currently are T-minus 38 minutes and counting from Wallops Island. The RockSat X is part of a program that introduces secondary institution students to building experiments for spaceflight and requires them to expand their skills to develop and build more complex projects. The experiments are flown approximately 20 miles higher in altitude than those on the Rock On and Rock Set C programs, providing more flight time in space. To share a little more about the payloads that each student group is flying today, we'll talk a little bit about each. And so Capital Technology University is testing an onboard satellite hotspot communication system using TCP/IP protocol by tapping into an existing network of communication satellites. The project intends to fly commercial off-the-shelf equipment that is TCP/IP compliant. The system uses an Android smartphone and an Iridium Go modem to send data from the rocket. The smartphone will pair with the Iridium Go via Wi-Fi and will create a mini Wi-Fi network on the rocket. The Android phone will then send data over the
PM video. And RSO, can you meet me on channel 5?
The Android phone will send data over the Iridium Go via the Wi-Fi network and out to the Iridium satellites to the operators on the ground. If successful, the system will be proved to be a cheaper alternative for payload communications.
Programmer, hold at 30.
Programmer, copy.
Holding clock at T-minus 30 minutes.
University of Colorado at Boulder, students have developed an induction heater that will melt two metals in microgravity. Aluminum and indium, which are immiscible in gravity, will mix together to create an alloy in the absence of gravity provided during the flight. The effects of solidification and microstructure.
All stations, this is the PM on channel 1 with a status update. The U.S. Coast Guard has just called and asked that we suspend launch operations while they conduct an air search and rescue in some of the areas of our Bay Capes areas. And at this time, they're saying that this operation will end at 0630 local. There's also always the potential of it exceeding 0630, but right now, they're saying till 6:30. So with that, we're holding at T-minus 30 minutes.
So as you hear, that's our program manager, Jack Vieira, letting us know that as we are on the water, of course, sometimes we have incidents nearby, and so this is certainly an incident that we will support. The United States Coast Guard is a great partner of ours, and they have asked us to at least put our mission on hold as they conduct a search and rescue operation. So certainly we will accommodate that and hope for the best, and that they're able to find whatever it is they seek to find. So we are T-minus 30 minutes in holding here from Wallops. While we are holding, it's a good opportunity to continue telling you a little bit about the student missions. talk a little bit about the University of Hawaii Community College mission. Four community colleges in Hawaii, all in affiliation with the Hawaii Space Grant Consortium, have teamed up to encourage students to explore STEM-based careers. UHCC's Project Amua Payload will make direct measurements of the sun's ultraviolet irradiance without atmospheric absorption. Variations in the UV components of the solar spectrum directly affect the Earth's atmosphere and ultimately the Earth's climate. Data will be analyzed to combine an understanding of solar dynamics. An array of photosensors for determining the orientation of the payload to the sun and a miniaturized IMU accelerometer built from off-the-shelf components make up the payload's two engineering experiments. Virginia Tech's student team has designed and built their own 3D printer to operate in space. They plan to collect information concerning the effects of changing gravitational loads on 3D printing. Virginia Tech hopes to provide meaningful results for future experiments concerning 3D printing and microgravity aboard a launch vehicle. The University of Nebraska at Lincoln's team will continue research on crystalline growth and microgravity. They aim to further
PM,
characterize.
PM, though, on one.
PM.
Yeah, if possible, I'd like to get us down as close as we can to T0 and hold there. And when we get our clearance, we can go. So I guess looking at the count, maybe 15 minutes.
Well, how about if we hold at T-minus 10 and then we get our wind weighting settings and then we can start right into the hot count from there?
Yeah, Roger, I like that even better.
Yeah, actually, sir, so I'd prefer if we could begin at a pole since we don't know how long we're going to be waiting. So if we decide to go to 10, I'd like us to redo the pole at 166 before we would pick up.
Yes, I agree with that.
Yeah, and I concur as well. Doesn't look like it's a whole lot in the count to get us from 30 down to 10. I don't think it's an issue right now.
We could jump the clock at any time, so the clock's not really my concern right now. I was on the phone with the Coast Guard to see what the impacts are. You know, window opens at 6, so we could jump the clock now if it really mattered. So let's just hold off for a minute, see what the Coast Guard's going to do.
Okay, that sounds good, John.
Yeah, TDR, so be advised, latest balloon data is still green for wind weighting, and we'll continue to update our balloons in order to be ready for best possible.
PM. I'm getting my P's and T's all mixed up here.
The University of Nebraska at Lincoln's team aims to further characterize crystal growth through the study of buoyant convection in a supersaturated solution of sodium acetate. They will be triggering a crystal to form at the apogee of the flight and study how crystals formed in microgravity are larger and more pure than in gravity. The Northwest Nazarene University experiment will test for functionality of American Semiconductor flex electronics in the sounding rocket environment. A flex analog to digital converter will collect data which will be sampled and stored for investigation after the flight. Additionally, the experiment will fly electronics intended for use on a future CubeSat. These electronics will be exposed to the space environment for testing.
ATS check 160.
Resealed using a deployable drawer system.
All right, so could you go to channel 5, please?
The University of Puerto Rico experiment will allow the detection of high-density particles found within the parameters.
ROAMNO.
Go ahead.
Just want to verify that we've reset the SIP software.
Thank you.
The University of Puerto Rico's experiments will allow detection of high-density particles found within the parameters of 130 to 165 kilometers above Earth sea level in order to study their physical and chemical properties. Achieving this through their early micrometeorite impact detection system, collector, and various other measuring devices, this project could aid in developing a clear image of space particles and potentially lead to the discovery and subsequent genome sequencing of organic materials found within the aforementioned particles. And finally, the University of Colorado at Boulder's ROCSAT-X high-definition video payload is intended to provide a view of the experiments from space. The system houses four HD cameras that record the flight and any deployments or activations on student experiments.
PM and RSO, TD on one.
PM.
They are going to hold off for us until and not attempt to enter the airspace until 6:25.
Okay, well, that's not enough time.
We need 5 more minutes.
Correct.
Copy. Stand
that
by.
We launch on the top.
And PM and RSO, we have till 06:30.
RSO copies.
PM copies.
And programmer TD.
This is programmer. Go ahead, TD.
Can you set the clock up for a T0 of 1000Z and pick it up?
Roger that.
PMMM.
PM.
Yeah, where are we on getting final launcher settings?
And RSO, do you have any initial wind ready settings for us?
Yeah, this is RSO. Stand by.
In 16 minutes and 30 seconds and counting, on my mark, mark.
So we're able to pick up our count, so we are currently at 16 minutes, 20 minutes, 16 minutes, 20 seconds.
ROA, this is RSO on channel one. Stand by to record the new settings.
Go ahead.
Roger, set your azimuth to 97.4. Set your elevation to 80.6.
97.4, 80.6.
Good readback.
You copy? LC, you copy launcher settings?
LC copies, in work.
MMPM on one. Say again, please. You were very weak. I could hardly hear you.
I copied RSO.
ROA PM, could we get a status on 160, 161, 162?
Check 160, check 161.
And TD, this is RSO channel one.
Go ahead.
Yeah, we need to confirm location of said helo. We don't have it on our screens right now, and we're going to need to have that location somehow provided to us so we can verify that they are, in fact, outside of our hazard area. We're not picking them up.
And RSO, he's still on deck. They're holding him on deck.
Copy is held on deck. Thank you.
So can we check 161?
Roger, 161 is checked. 161, we are projecting green for launch.
Copy. All stations, this is 46012 Terry Improved Malamute Launcher from Pad 2 RSC. Please stand by for station checks. Proceed with terminal count. All stations should... Mount status is green or red, channel one. RC?
RC is green.
M&O?
M&O green.
LWO?
LWO is green.
Computer?
Computer is green.
Programmer?
Programmer is green.
LC?
LC green.
LPM?
LPM green.
PLC?
Green.
PTM?
PTM green.
ACS?
ACS green.
ML?
MM green.
SRPO?
SRPO green.
PM?
PM green.
RSO?
RSO is green. We will need the one more balloon data.
Copy. And TD is green. All stations are responsible for reviewing the go-no-go criteria listed in the MOD. Only stations with an asterisk in previous step or permitted call a hold are the site should report red.
ROA LC. New launcher settings are in for the ARC launcher. Azimuth 97.4. Elevation 80.6.
Copy that.
And TD is RSO channel one.
Go ahead.
Because we picked up the way we did, we are going to have our last balloon data to you at about T minus 5 minutes as opposed to 12.
Copy, we can work with that.
And TDR, so the reason I'm bringing that up is a warning after step 188.
Copy. MM, did you copy?
Yes, we did.
T-minus 12 minutes and counting.
MM, channel one. Go ahead.
Yeah, you need to load those angles into Glenmac. Is that what the deal is?
Yeah, we don't want launcher movement while we're doing that.
All right, you're working that on your end that we'll get that afterwards?
That's a firm.
Roger.
T minus 10 minutes.
PLC check 171, 173, 174, 175, 176, 178.
PM, MNO.
PM.
RF parameters are in work. TM reports good luck. Check 181, 183.
ACS, check 177.
PTM, check 180.
PLC, check 182.
PTM, check 184. MNO PM.
No, can we check 172, 179?
Check 172. PTM, check 186, GPS acquired.
RC, interrogate transponder, please.
RC copies in work.
PTM, check 188.
ACS, check 185.
PM, this is RC on one.
PM.
You have a good 5 code?
Copy that. Check 187.
All stations, we are clear through 188 in count.
NRA, this is RSL. I'll get you 168 as soon as we can.
Copy.
PM, MM.
PM.
Yes, we can move the launcher inside 5 minutes. We don't want to go too far past that, but being as we jumped a little bit, we understand that.
Roger, copy.
T-minus 6 minutes and counting. Interesting fact for today, at max velocity, the vehicle will be traveling at 3,769 miles per hour.
TDR, so one.
Go.
Yeah, we're not going to have an answer for at least 3 more minutes or so.
PLC, check 189.
And, MM, you want to hold at 5?
Yes, please.
SRPO, you want to hold at 5 as well? You agree?
Yeah, let's go. MM, make the call.
Programmer, put us at 5 and holding, please.
Programmer, copies. Holding 5.
And I concur that we're pick up at 189. Everything's complete up to there, with the exception of launcher settings.
Copy.
And TD, this is our cell.
Go ahead.
Are we going to get some more time from the Coast Guard, or how's that being worked?
Yes, she's working it now.
Okay, roger.
You're good on the Coast Guard end.
Okay, roger, and you confirm that they're still on the ground?
Affirmative.
Okay, and we have some extra time until when?
Only ask for 5 more minutes.
Okay. PM, MM.
PM.
When we get those settings, we can pick the count up then. We don't need to wait for the launcher to be set. So that might help a little bit.
Okay, I copy that. TD, did you copy?
Yeah, we got it.
Yep.
Yeah, as soon as we RSO gives us the setting, let's pick it right up.
Without waiting for the even minute or go
pick
for the 30-second?
I would say pick it up as soon as he announces it. We got 2 minutes.
Copy, TD.
Yeah, TD copies.
ROA, this is RSO.
Go ahead.
Stand by to record new settings.
Programmer, you can pick up a clock.
Go ahead, sir. Set your azimuth to 97.9. Set your elevation 80.8.
LC, you copy?
LC copies. In work.
Repeat of the count. We're at T-minus 4
ROA
minutes,
LC.
40 seconds.
New launcher settings are in for the ARC launcher, azimuth 97.9, elevation 80.8.
Copy. PLC's on you.
PLC, check 190, 191, go.
We get 189.
189 was already done.
Roger, thanks.
We expect to see the first stage burnout at 5.2 seconds, with expected second stage ignition at 17 seconds. With burnout for the second stage at 28 seconds.
PLC going internal, 3, 2, 1, mark.
Payload is now operating on internal power.
ACS check 194.
PLC check 192, 193, 196, 198.
PMMNO check 199, check 200.
Copy.
ACS check 195.
PTM check 197.
PLC check 201.
PTM, check 202. PTM, check 203.
2 minutes and counting.
MNO, verify recorders are nominal.
Recorders nominal.
RC, status on transponder.
Radar has a good 5 code.
Check 204, 205.
ACS, check 206, 207.
ACS.
T-minus 1 minute.
Yes, go.
30 seconds.
PLC.
PLC is go.
PTM.
PTM is go.
SRPO.
SRPO is go.
Check 208, 209.
Coming up on 1 minute and counting.
1 minute. Fifty seconds.
LC Army Nation Certificate.
Minus 40.
LC, can I check 212?
LC copies. Ignition
minus
circuit 30. Is armed.
Minus 20.
ACS check 217.
Minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Plus 10.
Burnout.
TM tracking.
Second stage ignition.
Second stage ignition.
Plus 20. Plus 30. Plus 40. Plus 50. One minute.
D-spin. Motor set.
ACS active.
RSO, can we release roadblocks?
ACS rates nulled on target.
Sorry, so you are cleared to release the roadblocks.
Lima 8, ROA, Project 1.
And PM, this is RSO, Channel 1.
PM.
Yeah, be advised. We'd like to go ahead and ask for measurement before they bring the launcher down.
Yes, that was planned because of the elevation issue anyway, but yes, we will.
Very good. Thank you.
LPM, TD.
Go ahead, TD.
Did you copy that about the measurement?
Roger. We've planned for it.
Looking at pad 0A right now, which is where our Antares orbital ATK's Antares vehicle launches from. Everything's looking
past apogee at 156 kilometers.
Apogee actually was a little higher than we anticipated, so a little over 94 miles this morning. After what appears to be a successful launch this morning, that will conclude our broadcast here this morning from Wallops Flight Facility. You can check for updates by following us on Twitter at NASA underscore Wallops.
SOVM on one.
Or on Facebook.
ACS is spinning up.
This is RSO on one. Can I help you?
RSO. Has the recovery boat started moving in the direction east?
It's been taken care of, sir.
Thank
yes.
you. Thank you.
And PMSR, so we'll also be providing more accurate location information once that settles out.
Roger that.
But they are underway.
Perfect.
You can follow us on Twitter at NASA underscore Wallops, on Facebook at NASA's Wallops Flight Facility, or check us out on the web at www.nasa.gov/wallops. Once again, thank you for joining us this morning from Wallops Flight Facility, and congratulations to the Rockset X team. Have a good day.